How are you feeling?
Good. Blessed.
Good? You should feel good. You get to come to yoga and enjoy the community. Let's close the door. Right. If you need a strap or a block, grab one. And let's begin. So let's sit comfortably cross-legged. Spine long, shoulders back. Close your eyes. Bring yourself into the space. Begin to breathe in and out through the nose deeply. As you inhale, expand the belly over the room. And as you exhale, draw the belly in towards the spine. And just settle on your mat. Settle in the space. Settle in your body and settle in your mind. And place your hands together in prayer position in front of your heart. And take a moment here to make your intention of dedication for class. Let our minds be healthy, bodies healthy. And let's begin by chanting Om together once. Take a deep breath in. Bow your head, fold forward over your legs, keep your hips on the floor, keep the spine long, close your eyes, and take three deep breaths through the nose, inhaling, expanding the belly out, and exhale, drawing the belly in. Three deep breaths, two more deep breaths, one more deep breath. Your back, left hand on top of the right knee, and twist, look over the right shoulder. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, twist. Breathing through the nose deeply onto the right side of the body. And fill up your body with every breath you inhale. Exhale. One more deep breath. And then switch directions, rolling into the other. Twisting to the left hand behind your back, right hand on top of your right knee, the left knee. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, twist, breathing through the nose. Three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one, inhale gently back to the center. Bring your right arm by your side, walk your right hand out slightly. Bend your right elbow, reach the left arm up and over the head. Look under the left arm towards the ceiling. Breathing through the nose, extending through the fingertips. Inhale, lengthening. Exhale, opening. Two more breaths. And one, gently inhale, come up. Reach both arms up over the head, shoulders stay down. And exhale, left arm down, right arm up and over the head as you look under the arm towards the ceiling. Breathing through the nose deeply. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. And then gently inhale, coming up. Hands on your knees. Inhale, lift the chest, arch back. And exhale, round your back, seated cat cow, look towards your belly button. Inhale, lift your chest, arch back. Exhale, round the back and tuck your chin in, pull the belly in. Inhale, lift the chest, arch back. Exhale, round the back and tuck your chin into your chest. A few more rounds on your own, breathing deeply. Three. Good, smooth breath, two. Gently coming back to a neutral position of the spine and roll onto your hands and your knees. Come to all fours. And let's do a kneeling cat-cow. So your wrists are under the shoulders, knees are under the hips, point the toes back. Push the floor away from you. As you inhale, drop the belly, look up, shoulders back. Exhale, round your back and look towards your belly button. Good. Inhale, drop the belly, look up. And exhale, round your back and tuck your chin. And do a few rounds on your own. Breathing deep. And just being gentle with your body. How you can be gentle with your body is to be kind to yourself, so the thoughts in your head are loving, are calming, and come back to a neutral position of the spine. Good. Bring your knees together and walk your knees a little bit behind your hips. From here, you're going to drop your hips into a mini up dog. Move the hips all the way over to the right and push back into a child's pose, over to the left and forward. So you're making big circles with your hips. Pull the belly in as you're moving and plant those palms flush. Go as slow as you need to go. Accent the stretch wherever you need to feel it wherever is needed for your body, and then switch directions. So switch the direction of your hips. Circles in the other way. Two. One more big circle. And then come back to a center position and sit back in child's pose. Forehead on the floor, arms by your side or out in front of you. Close your eyes. Good. Closing your eyes, soften the face, soften the neck, soften the shoulders. And anytime you need to come into this pose, go ahead and do so. Gently inhale, come to all fours and tuck your toes under, lift your knees and your hips, downward facing dog. Begin to pedal your legs, bend one knee at a time. Bring the other heel towards the floor, side to side with your hips, side to side with your head. And anytime you need to bring the knees down, you can also bring the forearms down. Straightening both your legs, lift the right leg up, bend the right knee, and open up the hip towards the side. So lifting the right leg up towards the ceiling. Make circles with your ankle in one direction. Make circles with your ankle in the other direction. And then gently step that right foot all the way forward between the hands. Bring the left knee down to the floor. Point the left toes back, sink the hips. Bring the hands to the hips. Tuck the tailbone under, hold here, breathing deeply through the nose. For three deep breaths. Good. You got it, Ed. Two deep breaths. Open up the chest. One more deep breath. And then gently bring both hands to the floor. Step the right leg back into your downward facing dog. This can always be all fours, so listen to your body. And as you inhale, left leg up into the air, bend that left knee, open up the hip towards the side, make a circle with your ankle in one direction. And make a circle with your ankle in the other direction. Good, and then gently step that left foot all the way forward between the hands, bring the right knee down. Bring the hands to the hips and arch back, open up the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades together behind you. Hold here your lunge for three deep breaths. Breathing deeply. Two deep breaths. Hold. One more full breath. And then gently bring both hands to the floor and step the right foot forward to meet the left. So if you need to walk it forward, right foot forward. Good. Feet hip width apart. Grab onto your elbows, let your head dangle. You can bend one knee at a time. Just kind of gently move the torso side to side. Move your head side to side. You can just kind of dangle here. Pull the belly in towards the spine. Take three more breaths. Close those eyes if you can. Turn that attention inwards. Especially now, where there's so much going on externally, this is where we have a chance to self-reflect, to study, and check in with ourselves, and focus on the essential. Release your arms, tuck the chin into the chest, and slowly begin to roll up vertebra by vertebra, coming all the way up to standing.
Beautiful.
Reach your arms up over the head, grab your right wrist with your left hand, lengthen, and lean all the way to the left side, look under the right arm towards the ceiling. Anchor both your legs into the floor, pull the belly in, pull the shoulders down, and extend. Two deep breaths. And one, inhale, come back to the center, grab your left wrist, lengthen, and lean all the way over to the right side, look under that left arm towards the ceiling. Move the hips to the left, open up the chest, breathe the nose, pull the navel in. Two deep breaths here. One more deep breath. And come back to the center, release, interlace the fingers behind your back, bring your palms together. Push the hips forward, lean back. And then exhale, hinge at the hips, pull the belly in and drop the head, reach the arms up over the head. Good, so you can stay right here, relax the neck and the head. Take three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one, release and come all the way up with the flat back. Keep those hands interlaced, push those hips forward, lean back. And then back to the center. Toes and heels touching feet together, arms by your sides, Samasthiti. Lift the toes, spread the toes. Four corners of your feet anchor to the floor. Kneecaps lift, spiral the thighs in. Tuck the tailbone under. Find your stance here. Hold yourself in this space. You've already showed up for yourself in any way that you can. So now take it one notch higher, one notch deeper of allowing yourself to connect deeper within. Take two more breaths, not being afraid of what lies within. That's actually where the highest, most beautiful space is. One more breath. But we gotta get through the darkness to get through the light. Inhale, circle the arms up over the head, shoulders stay down, look up. Exhale, swan dive forward with the flat back, hands towards the floor, drop the head. Inhale, look up, lean forward, shoulders back. And exhale, just forward, bend over your legs. Inhale, reverse swan dive, press into the feet, reach the arms up over the head, shoulders stay down. Exhale, arms by your side. Good, again, inhale, circle those arms up over the head. Exhale, swan dive forward with the flat back, hands towards the floor, drop the head. Inhale, look up, lean forward. Exhale, forward, bend again. And inhale, press into the feet, look up first, arms out and out, reverse swan dive. Exhale, arms by your side. Good. Add the legs. Inhale, circle the arms up over the head, shoulders stay down. Exhale, swan dive forward with a flat back, hands towards the floor, drop the head. Inhale, look up, lean forward, shoulders back. Bend the knees, step the right leg back into a lunge. Sink the hips and look up, pull the belly in. And as you exhale, step that left leg back, pull the belly in, shoulders back. Inhale here. Exhale, bend the elbows. You can always bring the knees down, chaturanga. Point the toes and let's lift into a cobra. Squeeze the shoulder blades together, lengthen. Contract those back muscles, engage. And then lower down, tuck your toes under. Lift your hips downward towards the dog. Good. If you need to pedal your legs here again, go ahead. We're going to take three deep breaths. Breathing in through the nose, breathing out through the nose. Two deep breaths. One more full breath, let me hear you breathe. Good. Exhale entirely as you inhale, step the right foot all the way forward between the hands. Pause. If it doesn't reach, grab it, pull it forward. And then exhale, left foot to meet the right feet together. Inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, forward bend. And inhale, circle the arms out and up, shoulders stay down, look up. And exhale, arms by your side. Good, again, inhale, circle the arms up over the head, shoulders stay down. And exhale, swan dive forward with a flat back, hands towards the floor, drop the head. Inhale, look up, lean forward. And as you exhale, step the left leg back into a lunge, pause. Inhale, right leg back, plank position, top of the cushion. Slowly you can lower down the bottom of the push-up chaturanga. Point the toes, lift the chest for cobra or up dog, strong legs. And exhale, tuck your toes up and lift your hips.
Downward facing dog.
Looking towards your belly button, spread the fingers, hold here. Three full breaths. Gentle vinyasa. Two deep breaths. One more full deep breath in. Exhale entirely. And as you inhale, step the left foot all the way forward between the hands. Pause. Exhale, right foot to meet the left. Inhale, look up, extend. Exhale, forward, then drop your head. And inhale, circle your arms out and up, look up. And exhale, arms by your side. Beautiful. Bend your knees and come into a chair pose. Utkatasana. Sink the hips. Get the hips back. Arms up. Draw the ribs in. Pull the belly in and up. Arm the thighs in towards each other. Hold for two deep breaths. In your chair pose. One more full breath here. And exhale, forward bend, drop your head. Inhale, look up, lean forward. And exhale, hands to the floor. You can step or float back. Come to the top of the push-up. Lower down and chaturanga. Point the toes, lift the chest up, dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale, right leg up into the air. Bend that right knee. Open up that hip again. Don't let the shoulders get out of place. So make sure they're still parallel to the floor. And then step that right foot all the way forward between the hands. Keep the left knee lifted. Spiral the thighs in. Pull the belly in. Lift the torso. Press to the base of the right big toe. Draw the ribs in. Beautiful. Three deep breaths. Hold this lunge. Good. Reach those arms up over your head. Shoulders stay down. Two deep breaths. Keep bending that right knee. Good. One more full deep breath in. And as you exhale, both hands come down to the floor. Step the right leg back. Bring your feet together. Pivot to the outside of the right foot. Lift the left arm up into a side plank. You can always bring the right knee down if you need to. Hold here. Push the floor away from you for three full breaths. You got it. Two. Come on. Stay with me, guys. You're already physically here. Be mentally here. One more deep breath. Not just going through the motions. Exhale, left hand down plank. Exhale, lower down bottom of the push-up. Inhale, up dog, cobra, Uddiyana Vrishvanasana. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg up into the air, bend the left knee. Open up the hip, but keep the shoulders parallel to the floor. Breathe the nose. Good. And then step that left foot all the way forward between the hands. Keep the right heel lifted. And circle the arms out and up. Shoulders stay down. Pull the belly in. Good. Spiral the thighs in towards each other. Stabilize. Draw those ribs in. And no matter how many times you've done a lunging warrior, you're not doing it from yesterday or tomorrow. It's right here, right now. So give this pose purpose. Deep breath in, highest essential here. Deep breath out. One more deep breath in. And exhale, circle the hands to the floor. Step the left leg back, bring your feet together. Side plank on your left side. Left hand down, right hand up, and look up at the right thumb. Open up the chest, good. Hold here, three deep breaths. Push the floor away from you. Two deep breaths, any variation with that top leg that you need to do, good. One more deep breath in with those hips. And exhale, right hand back, chaturanga, bottom of the push-up. Inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Take a moment here to check in with your thoughts. What have you been carrying this whole class? What's in your practice? Deep breath in, mental practice, not your physical one. We know your physical one because it's the sequence we're doing, but that has nothing to do with what's going on between your ears. So check in with that, make that gentle, make that kind, make that loving, make that positive. One more breath in. Exhale entirely. Bend your knees. You can choose to step or hop forward between the hands. Look up, flat back. Exhale, forward bend, drop your head. Don't we bend those knees for chair pose, utkatasana, sink those hips, reach those arms up over the head, get deep into those hips. Yes. Hold here, five, breathe, four, good, three, get a little lower, come on, two, and exhale, forward bend all the way down, hands to the floor, uttanasana. Inhale, look up, extend. Exhale, you can step or flow back, slowly lowering down to the bottom of the cushion. Inhale, up, down, cobra, and exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Step the right foot forward between the hands. Bring the left heel to the floor. Circle the arms up over the head. Coming up into your warrior one. Vita Vinyasa one. Heel to heel, back foot 45 degrees from the front foot. Spiral the thighs in towards each other. Bend that right knee. Hold. Breathe through the nose for three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. Get low into it. Sink that hip. Outer edge that left foot on the floor. And one open to warrior two. Heel to arch. Look past that right middle finger. And extend in opposite directions. Good. Sink that hip low. Breathe the nose. Be aware of your body's space. What is your right fourth toe doing right now? Which maybe you've never thought about it before, except for right now, and that's a beautiful thing. Become aware of every inch. Holding that warrior two. And then inhale, reverse warrior, left arm down the left leg, right arm up and over, sink that hip. So again, no matter how many times you may or may not have been doing these poses, it's new because it's different today. You've grown from yesterday. You are a different person today than you were yesterday. And you will be a different person tomorrow, depending on where you're at. Get a little lower into that hip. So we condition ourselves into the positive mental space. One more breath here. And then straighten out the right leg. Walk the left foot closer to the right. Reach over the right leg, right hand down, left hand up. Look up at that left thumb. Open up the chest and engage the legs. Spiral the thighs away from each other. Breathe the nose. Beautiful. Activate those fingertips. Push the floor away from you and pull into the midline. Three breaths. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. Keep opening the chest to the left. And then gently look down, left hand on the waist. Bend the right knee. Cup the right hand to the outside of the right foot. Push off that right leg. Stack the hips and stack the shoulders, coming into your half moon, Ardha Chakrasana. You need to use the block, put the hand on the block, and open up that chest. Breathe through the nose. You got this. Good. So the level of your intensity of your practice has 100% to do with you. Not with the sequence, not with the pose. But what you're doing in the pose, physically and mentally, so bring it for yourself, 100%. Two more breaths. Good. One more full breath. And then gently lower the left hand down, coming to your standing split, seeing if you can grab your ankle with one or both hands, or use a block. Breathe the nose. Hold here. Three deep breaths. Good. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. And then gently step that left leg back into a lunging warrior. So your right knee stays bent. Reach the arms up over the head to come back. Come on, let's use that right leg. We're here for pull the belly and shoulders down. And bring your hands in prayer in front of your heart. Lean over that right leg. Push that left heel back, right knee forward, pull the belly in, pause here for 3 breaths. Find your happy place here. 2 deep breaths. You can hear you breathe, let me know you're alive. 1 more deep breath. And push up into a warrior 3. Lift that left leg up. Oh, I know that right thigh loves me so much, and I love everyone's right thigh collectively. 3 deep breaths. Here you go. 2 deep breaths. Good. 1 more deep breath. We're in a warrior 3. We are hovering in a T. 1 more breath here. Bring the left leg back into a lunge. Reach the arms above the head. Find your control. And then circle the hands to the floor. Step that right leg back. And go, woo! The right thigh is cooked. Inhale up dog. Exhale down dog. Beautiful. Inhale left foot forward between the hands. All the way. Bring the right heel down to the floor. Pull the belly in. Spiral the thighs in and reach the arms up over the head. Good. Come on. Pull the belly in and hold in this position. Breathe. So the right heel is flat to the floor. Right heel down, warrior 1. Heel to heel. Left knee bent above the ankle. Spiral the thighs in towards each other. Extending the arms above the head. Always anchoring yourself in your center. Good. 2 more breaths. 1 more breath. And exhale, warrior 2. Heel to arch, widen the stance. Bend that left knee above the left ankle. Spiral the thighs away from each other. And extend. Pull the belly in. Extending in opposite directions. Sink that hip low. Shoulder blades draw in towards each other. Down. And extend. Good. And make sure that your breath is happening because you are telling it to, not just because you happen to be breathing. That's the rest of your day. You just breathe because it's involuntary. But make this voluntary. Make it intentional. Hold here. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. You've already made it so far. Inhale, reverse warrior, leaning back. Open up the chest and dig deep. Sink that hip for 3. Good. Extending that left arm. 2. 1 more deep breath. And then gently inhale, straighten out that left leg. Walk the right foot closer. Bring the left hand down. Right hand up and look up at that right thumb. So it's a triangle, not a twisted triangle. Left hand down, right hand up, and extend in opposite directions. Good. Breathe in the nose. 3 deep breaths. Come on, feel your breath passing through your body. Anchor your 4 corners and feet on the floor. 2 deep breaths. 1 more deep breath. And gently bend that left knee. Cup the left hand in front of the left foot over to the left as you lift the right leg up and come into your half moon. Always use support if you need it with a block, with whatever's around you that you can support yourself in. Open the hips. Pull the belly in. That's it. Take your time. There's no need to push. Hold for 3 deep breaths. Open that chest, 2 deep breaths. Good, 1 more deep breath here, hold. And then lower that right hand down, coming into that standing split. So you know your left thigh is going to be burning because your right thigh was burning before. Hold here, grab your ankle with one or both hands, or bring the hands to the floor, holding your space here, not just physically but mentally. Checking in with yourself where your edge is and being at that edge for 3 deep breaths, but comfortably. two. Good. One more deep breath. And then gently bend that left leg. Step the right leg back into a lunging warrior. Reach the arms up over the head. Shoulders stay down. Good. Holding here. And then hover over that left thigh. Push that right heel back. Come on. Dig deep, guys. Breathe in. Breathe out. We're just going through some gentle poses here that might be obviously burning the thigh, but it's not something that's going to make or break. You're stabilizing yourself and going to your edge. And then push off into a warrior three. Lift that right leg up, pull that belly in. Warrior three, lifting that right leg and finding your space. Ujjayi breath in, ujjayi breath out. Good. Three breaths. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. Come on, come on, come on. And step that right leg back, lunging warrior again. Yay! Because it's over. Both hands to the floor. Step that left leg back. Vinyasa. Doesn't Vinyasa never look so good? Inhale up dog. Strong legs, exhale, down dog. Good job, guys. If you need child's pose, bring your knees to the floor, sit back on your heels and rest. Otherwise, stay in your down dog or any variation that your body is asking for. Close your eyes, breathe through the nose. Good, three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. Remember, the positive thoughts in your head are the most important position you can put yourself in. Mental position. The rest will come easily if your head is in the right spot. Focused on the higher essentials, the rest will come. Actions will happen that line up with that. Instead of forcing yourself to try to do an action in a negative headspace, it's not going to come out right. And then extend your arms in front of you. Come back into your down dog if you're not already there. And then gently walk from your down dog. Walk your hands back towards your feet. Grab your toes and yogi toe lock. If you can reach, inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, forward bend. If you can't reach, just grab your legs or bend your knees. And relax the neck, relax the head. Pull the toes up towards the head and head down towards the toes. Three deep breaths, Kapha-Mustasana. Two deep breaths, Ujjayi in, Ujjayi out. And then one, now inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, grab your left leg with your right hand and lift your left arm up and twist, looking up at the left thumb. So you're facing the left wall. Right hand grabs the left leg, lift the left arm up and breathe through the nose. Good. Four deep breaths. Three deep breaths. Keep the ujjayi breath. Two. Now listen carefully. From here, you're going to cup the right hand in front of the right foot. If you have to use a block, use a block. Lift the right leg up. Keep that left arm up and just twist into a twisted half moon. So lifting the right leg up. You're balancing on your right hand and your left foot. Left palm faces the left wall and push the floor away from you. Pull the belly in and hold for three. Anchor, lift that right leg as high as you can. Good. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. Now listen carefully. Left hand on your waist. Pull the belly in. Bend the left leg a little bit. Lift the torso with control and bring this right foot into your inner left thigh for tree pose. Vinyasa. Right foot into the inner. That's it. Hands in prayer, shoulders back. Now imagine that there's a harness at the base of your skull and your chin, and it's pulling straight up. So the chin isn't going up. Everything's going up. And you're elongating. The shoulders pull down. The head pulls up. Press down into that left leg and push evenly your right foot into your left leg as your left leg pushes into your right foot. Beautiful. Look at one spot in front of you that's not moving. Breathe through the nose. Anchor yourself in the higher essentials. And nothing will make you fall. Nothing will make you lose your center, even if your body falls. Bring the right leg in front of you. Pause, pull the belly in length, and then slowly lift that right leg up into standing split, hands to the floor, and lower the right leg down. And kind of shake out the legs a little bit. You're gonna forward bend with your feet width apart. Grab your right ankle with your left hand, lift the right arm up, twisted position here, twisted forward bend. Three full breaths through the nose. Two deep breaths. Good, one more deep breath here. And now you're gonna bring your left hand in front of your left foot. Shift the weight into the right leg and lift the left leg up, right hand up, twisted half moon. So it's a little bit sometimes mentally tricky because your right hand is up but the right leg is down. Left hand is down but the left leg is up. Ooh, gotta love how yoga makes us be present because you can't think about anything else. So you should be facing the right wall. Your left hand is down, your right hand is up. Three deep breaths. Good. Two deep breaths. You're still on that right leg. Good. Holding here. And then bring that right hand to the waist. And then slowly press into that right leg as you lift it up and bring that left knee in. Open up the knee to the side. Stabilize and come into your tree pose. So you're going to press that left foot into the right leg. So don't fall into the right leg. Push down, crown the head up, and you bring your hands in prayer over your head, whatever variation of your arms, as long as you are focused. Recall that intention you set for class. What was the reason for you showing up for yourself today? Deep breaths in. Deep breaths out. Good. Shoulder blades drawing together behind you, crown of the head is reaching up. Feeling safe is not a physical thing, but a mental thing. You can have someone in their own bed, but mentally unsafe. And you can have somebody in a very physically compromising situation, but mentally safe. So safety is a mental thing. That's why we practice philosophy. Bring the left knee in front of you, because it keeps things in perspective. And slowly bring that left leg back, standing split, bring the hands to the floor. Pull that left leg way up high, and then lower that left leg down. Forward bend, and walk your hands forward into a downward facing dog. Good. Feet hip width apart, hands shoulder width apart. Spread the fingers wide, heels down, toes up, lengthen. Beautiful. And as you inhale, lift the right leg up into the air. Exhale, right knee into the chest. Try to kiss that right knee around the back. Good. Inhale, right leg up into the air. Lift that right leg up high. Exhale, right knee towards the right shoulder, right elbow around the back, lean forward. Inhale, right leg way up high, lean back. Exhale, right knee to the left elbow around. Inhale, right leg up. And exhale, right knee into the chest, hold, forehead towards the knee, hold for three, try to kiss that knee, lean forward, two, come on, flare up the belly a little bit, flare up those arms, one more deep breath, and then step that right foot to the outside of the right hand, sink the hips, coming into your lizard pose here, your back knee can be on or off the floor, yogi's choice, you can walk your hands forward, bring the elbows to the floor, and let's open up our hip here. Pull the belly in, ankle right under the knee. So walk that right foot as far forward as you need to until the ankle's right under the knee. Breathing through the nose. Hold. Just three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. Is that better? Good. You can try to walk this foot forward a little bit if it's not too much. There you go. Is that okay? Good. One more deep breath. And you can stay right here. Option A is to stay right here. Option B is to bend this left leg behind you. Reach the right arm back. You can come up onto your hand and catch your left foot with your right hand and twist to the right. Otherwise, stay in this position. Five breaths. Four deep breaths. Sink the hips, lift the chest. Two deep breaths. One more full breath. And then gently release. Straighten out the right leg. And forward bend over that right leg. Good. So the right leg straightens. Forward bend, forehead towards the shin. And breathe here. If you want to slide into a split, go ahead. Pull the belly in. Breathe through the nose. And hold for five. For four. A little gentle vinyasa flow this morning. Two. And one, gently pull that right leg back in and walk the right foot to the left. Bring the right knee down to the floor. We're going to come into a pigeon pose. So if you need to grab this right foot with your left hand, you want that to stabilize. Slide that left leg back, square those hips, lift the chest, pull the belly in, and then walk your hands forward into a pigeon pose. So breathe through the nose, pull the belly in, lengthen, close your eyes here. And make this enough. Because anytime your externals are enough without being complacent, that means that you feel full. Think about what that means. If something's not enough, you're not happy until you get this, or unless you get this, then you're not full. Something's missing. You're feeling a void. Feel that. Let's make this pose enough for us today. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. Gently inhale, walk your hands up, lift your chest. Listen carefully. From your pigeon pose, sit on your right butt cheek and swing the left leg around. Bring the right foot to touch the inner left thigh, left leg straight, lift up the chest. Reach the arms up over the head and try to create a nice elongation of the spine. Even if you can kind of bend your knee and hinge forward, and then exhale, forward bend over that left leg. Close your eyes and enjoy this pose. Again, making this pose enough. You are not lacking anything. Everything you have is within yourself. No amount of toilet paper will ever make you feel full. It's okay. I'm feeling good. Thank you. My nephew says, I'm the silliest in the family. Doesn't know all of it, doesn't. Three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one, gently inhale, lift. Left arm on the inside of the left leg. You're going to bring the right arm up and over the ear to grab out towards your left foot. If you don't reach your foot, no big deal. Just open the chest. So use that left arm as a lever to open and create the traction you need. Otherwise, gravity is going to pull that right shoulder down. So keep opening it up. Three breaths. Good. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. And then gently inhale, palming up. Cross that right leg over the left. Right hand behind your back. Left elbow, shoulder, the outside of that right knee. As you twist and look over that right shoulder. And breathe through the nose. Inhale deeply. Exhale, twist a little deeper. Good. Lengthen on every inhale and twist on every exhale. Two breaths. And one, gently release. Hands on either side of the left and bring the forehead towards the floor to release the spine a bit. Yeah, you just kind of bring your hands on either side, do a little boop-boop. And then you come back up. Boop-boop. There you go. You gotta make the sound effect. Lift the legs, bone pose, Navasana. Lift the chest, shoulders back. Try to be on the front edge of the sit bones. And only if your hamstrings and quads can do it, then straighten your legs. But if you straighten your legs and lean back, then you need to stay forward. Four more breaths. I know you've already been here. Stay with me. Three. It's a little trick I use. I explain. Two. Make you stay present. Hold one more full breath here. Stay with me. Half boat pose. Back on the floor. Head up, heels up. Look at the toes. Five breaths. Hold. Four. Calm. Dig deep. Three. Calm. Two. And come back up to your boat pose. Five. Yes. Four. Come on. Three. You know you're going to get yumminess on the left side now, so two more breaths. Perspective, right? Everything passes. And then cross your ankles, roll onto your hands and your knees, and step into your down dog. Woo-hoo! Good job, guys. Finishing strong. Inhale, left leg up into the air. Bend the left knee, open it up. And then exhale, left knee into the chest. And kiss your knee, round your back, lean forward. Inhale, left leg up into the air. Exhale, left knee into the chest, round your back. Lower to the left elbow, excuse me. And then inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left knee to the right, elbow across it. Lean forward, inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left knee to the center, forehead to the knee. Hold, kiss your knee as much as you can. Heel to the glute for three, hold. For two, come on. And one, step that left foot to the outside of the left hand. You can bring the back knee down or up and walk your hands forward into a nice, yummy lizard pose stretch. Hold your ankle under the knee, not knee in front of the ankle. Good. And bring that knee in towards the shoulder. So squeeze that's it, inner thigh. And breathe through the nose, ujjayi breath in, ujjayi breath out. Good, hold in here. I'm gonna hear you breathe. Two more breaths. One more full breath. And then gently bring the right knee down, bend your right leg, reach back with your left hand to catch your right foot. That's it. So if you can't find your foot, if it's not possible, it's no big deal. You're still feeling a quad stretch and a hip flexor stretch and iliopsoas stretch in this lunge. Just stay in the twist. Three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. Keep lifting that left side of the ribcage a little bit. One more deep breath. And then gently release. Straighten out the left leg in front of you. Forward bend into your waterfall. Hip above the knee. Foot flex or slide that left foot all the way forward into the splits. And breathe through the nose. Good. Hold here. Close your eyes for four deep breaths. Three deep breaths. Two. And one. Gently bend into that left leg. Walk the left foot to the right and come into your pigeon pose on your left side. Right leg slides back. Left ankle towards the right wrist. If this hurts your knees, sit all the way to the left hip or do your number four stretch. Lengthen as you inhale and then exhale. Walk your hands forward and find the yumminess in this pose here. Find your own yumminess. And again, reminding yourself that you are enough, that this is enough. Everything that comes and goes is part of it all. Nothing is meant to last forever. And nothing is meant to be gone forever. Honoring the process. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Sit onto your left hip and swing the right leg around in front of you. Left foot touches the inner right thigh. Make sure you're up on your sit bones so you're not collapsing back. Rotate forward. Flex the foot, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, forward bend over the right leg. Toes up to the face, so make that leg active. Press the left hip down. Nobody panic, that was just some water in my throat. Two deep breaths. And one inhale, gently lift right arm on the inside of the right leg. Open up the chest. So use that hand to open up the chest and bring the left arm up and over the head. Deep breaths. Lengthen both sides of your body. Create the space between each vertebra. Hold for three. Close those eyes. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. And gently inhale, lifting up the chest. Bring the left leg over the right. Seated spinal twist, left hand behind the back, right elbow to the outside of the left knee. So left leg is over the right knee, facing the left wall. And twist, look over the left shoulder. Deep breaths. Four. Press both sit bones into the floor. Perplexing the belt like that. Three. It is gorgeous. Two. And one, inhale back to the center, do a little counter pose, hands on the other side, forehead towards the floor, just like a little release of the spine. Good, and then come back to the center. Bring your forearms to the floor, straighten out the left leg. So try not to collapse into the chest here. Lift up the chest, lift the heels, and lift up off the floor. Transition to the floor. Five breaths. I tricked you. Four. Three, we're getting there slowly, I promise. Two, and now reach your arms by your side, lower the back to the floor. Three more breaths here, guys. Come on, dig deep. Two, you can always bring one leg down if your back hurts. One more deep breath, hold, and then hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little love hug. Close your eyes. Good, and bring your feet to the floor, feet hip-width apart, arms by your side. Press and lift the hips, coming into your bridge pose or full wheel, hands under the shoulders, lift up the hips. And four more breaths. Ankles are right under the feet, press the feet into the floor, spiral the thighs in towards each other. Two deep breaths, keep lifting, keep lengthening. Good, inhale, one more deep breath, lift up, 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 up. And exhale, lower down slowly. The tailbone is the last thing to come down, so tuck it under and come down. Yes, hands in prayer position on the spot between the eyebrows. Close your eyes. Take a breath here. And then straighten out your left leg. Bring the right knee in towards the chest. Hug your knee in tight. Give yourself a nice little hip stretch here. Hamstring stretch. And then cross that right leg over to the left side of the body. And look to the right. Recline, spinal twist. Keep your eyes closed. Soften the jaw, soften the face, soften the shoulders. Tongue relaxes. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. And then gently inhale back to the center. And switch right leg out, left leg in. And cross that left leg over the right side of the body. And twist to the left. Look over that left shoulder. Shoulders relax, face relaxes, body lets go. Be grateful for today. Gently. So we're trying to bring people in.
Thanks, guys.